Did you work for hours and hours on the same bank reconciliation and you just can't find the difference? Well, you can't finish reconciling until you find the difference and account for it. And if you can't, then in order to move on, you have to adjust your bank reconciliation. That's what this video is all about. There are only two possible reasons why you have a difference at the end of the bank reconciliation process. If there is a difference you can't find, it's either because you're reconciling an old account for the first time and the amount you need to adjust is called a beginning balance adjustment. That's not what we're talking about in this video. I already made a prior video about beginning balance adjustment, and you can find the link to that video down in the description field under the table of contents. But this video is about the other reason why you have a difference and need to adjust. If you're not reconciling an old account, what it means is that difference is showing you that there's a mistake in the past somewhere that you just didn't find. That's it. And sometimes people reconcile for many hours and they simply can't find that mistake. Well, the only way to handle that, even though it's wrong, is to simply adjust your bank reconciliation so you can at least move on with your life. But when is it acceptable to adjust it in that case, and when is it not? In the field of accounting, there's a concept called the materiality principle. The materiality principle states that if there is a difference that you can't find and the amount is so small that it will not make a difference, then it is acceptable to adjust for it and move on because that difference will not change anything. For example, if you're reconciling a bank account that has $1 million and it has 1,000 transactions a month, and when you get to the end of the reconciliation, there's a 3-cent difference, do you think it's worth it to keep going back and redoing the entire bank reconciliation because you can't find 3 cents? Well, in that case, the difference is so immaterial that it would not make sense to lose thousands of dollars paying people to do the reconciliation over and over again just to find 3 cents. So even though it's technically wrong to adjust the bank reconciliation in that case, for practical purposes, you have to do it. You have to click the adjust button when you get to the end of the bank reconciliation process. So exactly what happens at the moment you click the adjust button when you're trying to finish your bank reconciliation? Well, we know that the bank balance did not match the cleared balance inside your QuickBooks Online. So when you click adjust, you're actually forcing QuickBooks Online to change the QuickBooks Online cleared balance to make it match the bank balance. That's what's happening. So QuickBooks Online is recording an adjustment, an entry that changes the balance of the bank account that you're working on during the reconciliation process. But wait a minute, we learned that for every entry that changes one account in the chart of accounts, there has to be another entry that changes another account in the chart of accounts. Because for every debit, there's an equal and opposite credit. So if QuickBooks Online is changing the balance of your bank account, in order to keep the debits and credits balanced, there has to be another account in your chart of accounts that also records the adjustment. In this case, the balancing account that records any adjustment to a bank account in order to fix your reconciliation, this account has a special name. It's called Reconciliation Discrepancies. And if you open your trial balance and you double click and open up the reconciliation discrepancy account, you will see every adjustment that you ever made to every bank reconciliation that you ever needed to adjust. And it will show the amount and the date, and you can put in the memo field anything that you think is important about that adjustment and that particular month's bank reconciliation. We're about to do an example now of adjusting the reconciliation, and you will see that account appear on your trial balance for the very first time. Now, I'm going to show you an example of exactly how this works, but I want to quickly mention that this video is only one video in the bank reconciliation series. And if you wish to follow along with me with this video and all the others, you can look even lower in the description field and find the link to download the bank statements and all the instructions so that you can follow along with me in this example, step by step. Well, at the moment you do a force fit adjustment at the end of the first reconciliation that you're doing this with, QuickBooks Online will create a new account in the chart of accounts called Reconciliation Discrepancies. And it's an account that QuickBooks Online automatically creates the very first time that you make this type of adjustment. And the account type of Reconciliation Discrepancies is Other Expense, which means it's not something that shows up in the top or even in the middle of the profit and loss. This particular account will show up under the net operating income to show you that it increases your profit and loss, but not from your normal operations. So now we're going to do the May bank reconciliation together, and we're going to pretend to make a mistake that causes the reconciliation to not balance, and we'll be stuck with a difference. Then we'll force it to fit with the adjustment feature and see what happens. Now we're going to pretend the mistake is a typical stupid thing that distracts a person when they look at the statement, causing them to make a silly mistake. For example, let's imagine that there's the real ending balance listed on the statement, but for some reason, the bank put another number that we didn't understand, like unreserved balance or something weird with a weird name. And let's pretend we actually accidentally put that number as the ending balance instead of the true ending balance. If we do that, that's a mistake that will prevent the numbers from reconciling and getting a difference of zero. So that will be our example reason why we have to adjust May's reconciliation. Now here we are in front of May's bank statement. And the first thing we're going to do is the mistake that causes the adjustment. We're going to enter the wrong balance because we're pretending we were distracted by another number on the statement. And you can see there's only a $50 difference between the wrong number that we're putting in and the correct ending balance. So let's go ahead and reconcile. We click the cog wheel and come over to reconcile. And it remembers that I, your teacher, was actually playing around with May's reconciliation before we started. So I'm going to click resume reconciling, but you'll be in the first window. So because I had to skip the first window, when you're in the first window, make sure you put the correct put the wrong ending balance, because we want to see what happens. And we put the proper ending date of the statement, which in our example is the ending date of May. So even though I'm putting this in the second window, you'll put it in the first window if you didn't already start May's reconciliation. Then when you click save, this is the difference you should have between the statement balance that's wrong and the cleared balance that has accumulated so far from past reconciliations. Now we'll just do the same process that we did 5 or 6 times prior, and you notice it's kind of a small reconciliation with not too many transactions.
so we can get through it quickly, especially with the practice we already had. So let's start out doing what we already do. We highlight the one we're looking for, then we go and look for that 400. If we find it, we mark it as cleared, and then on the bank statement, we color it in to indicate it was marked as cleared, and it's part of the cleared balance. I will move a little faster. There's $1,200 from Alan. We can find that here, mark it off, come back to the highlight and color it in. There's $35 fee to Chase Bank. There it is, so we mark it off, come back here and color it in. There's $26.60 to Betty Boop, probably a refund. Let's look for the $26.60 carefully. There it is. And again, you can pause the video or slow down the video to your liking. But I'm going quickly because most of us already know how to do this. There's $5.94 to UPS, so we mark that off. If you need time to find it, you can pause the video. There's $19.20.80 that came in from Betty. So there it is. We mark it off nicely. And again, you could even slow the speed of the video if you need to. $16.65. Where is it? Oh, where is it? Where is it? There it is. We mark it off. And we color it in. Now there's $900 here. So normally there would be more clarity in a real situation, but that's the only $900. We assume it's right. Reese's Repair Ranch, we paid $300. So where's that $300 to Reese's Repair Ranch? Okay, look closely for an amount of $300. There it is, mark it off, Reese's Repair Ranch. Okay, now there are only two left. And again, this is my favorite moment. Watch. When I mark off the second to last one on the statement, you see that the difference is not the remaining amount of the last transaction. The last transaction is $500, which we can mark off. And notice there's still a $50 difference that we just can't make fit. We happen to know in this case, it's because we put in $50 wrong amount as the ending balance. We made a $50 mistake when we put that in, and logically that explains it in this case. But if we didn't know it, we'd be going crazy. Where is the $50 difference? So we see that what we're going to do in this case is force it to fit with an adjustment. Now, don't worry, because the video that follows this one is going to show you how to undo a bank reconciliation so you can make your corrections and do it again properly. But before we learn how to undo, we now have a reason to undo this reconciliation. We're about to screw it up by forcing it to fit with an adjustment. So watch, we can't get it to fit. We can't get it to work. So to make it fit, we go to the top right, and instead of clicking Save for Later, we click this pull down arrow and click Finish Now. Now we're going to get this warning saying, excuse me, your difference is not zero. You aren't reconciled because you have a difference, blah, 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 blah. But we know we screwed it up, so we're going to click Add Adjustment and Finish. Now, even though we got this message that your account is reconciled and we click Done, we know there's a $50 difference. And at the moment we clicked Finish Now and said do it anyway, QuickBooks Online adjusted our bank balance for that $50. Let's take a look. If we go to the chart of accounts by clicking the cogwheel and we go over to the chart of accounts, you will see that there's a new account in the chart of accounts, and we could just, instead of scrolling through everything, DI, and you can see there's a new account, Reconciliation Discrepancies. And if we take a look at it, we can't really view the register because you can see the account type is other expense. But what we can see is if we clear this and we go back to the cash and bank account and view the register, we can see when we open up the bank account register that the very latest entry in the cash and bank account is this adjustment for $50. And it's on the payment side because we had to lower the cleared balance in our records in order to match what we thought was the bank balance. So here is the entry in the cash and bank actually changing the balance. And you saw the account was added. Now let's take a look at what it looks like on the profit and loss. If we go to reports, we can go to the standard area of the reports and go down to find profit and loss, which is under the favorites. Now, after I click profit and loss, you know I always like to show the results of all transactions, regardless of date, and run the report. And if we go to the very, very bottom of the profit and loss, we see that the operating income, after subtracting expenses from the operating income, the net operating income is here. Now we have other income for reasons that have nothing to do with our operations and other expenses that have nothing to do with our operations, one of which is the reconciliation discrepancy. Then we have the true net income. Now we know this reconciliation discrepancy should not be here, which means somehow, some way, you still have to find and fix this. But don't worry, because coming soon in a future chapter, we will learn how to undo a reconciliation. So soon, we're going to go back and undo May's reconciliation, put in the correct ending balance, and do it correctly. But at least you saw in this video chapter exactly how it works when you force it to fit with a reconciliation adjustment.